If I want to be able to identify persons of interest in the Enron dataset, of course, a really important thing to do is to define what I mean by a person of interest. So I thought about this for a while, and I came up with a few different things that might define a person of interest. Maybe they were someone who was indicted, which means they were charged with a crime. Another possibility, and there were several people like this, is that a person of interest could be someone who settled without admitting guilt. So that usually means that they paid a fine, but there were no criminal charges, and they didn't admit that they were involved in the fraud in any specific way. It's a little bit of a judgment call whether you should include these people, so that I would have as many examples as possible of persons of interest. And then a third possibility is a person of interest could be someone who testified for the government in exchange for immunity from prosecution. Now I want to show you a list I made of all the persons of interest that I was able to identify. So in this POI.txt file, I just have a list of names. This first line here is actually an article that I found very helpful in trying to identify all the people who were persons of interest. And it was interesting because this was really a manual problem to come up with this list. In all the examples that we've done so far, you just kind of have the data handed to you and it already has class labels assigned. So it's really simple. But here what I had to do was actually go out and figure out who should be assigned the class label of person of interest. So all those people, I found their names using newspaper articles basically, and I wrote them all down. You can see there were quite a few of them. This is consistent with it being one of the largest corporate fraud cases in American history. All told, I count about 35 people, 30 of whom or so worked for Enron. The rest were working at other firms, but they were doing business with Enron. And one thing that I want to point out is that this list might not be perfect. I made it by hand, and there's completely the possibility that I missed someone or I missed several people. And so in the videos to come for the rest of the class, I'll show you what I did, but I'll also try to point out places where it's possible that mistakes could sneak in. So you should always be skeptical of the things that I find, and you should try to check them out yourself. So if you're really interested, go through this list and see if you can find anyone else who should be on it. And if so, post it to the forums.